Hi everybody, my name is Dr. Seema Shah Fairbank, and in today's video you'll learn about the hydrologic budget. After watching this video, you should be able to perform a hydrologic budget on a hydrologic system. A hydrologic system is a lake, reservoir, or dam, segments of a river, stream, canal, roadway, and many other things. You must be wondering, so what is a hydrologic budget? You could think of it similar to a bank account. We deposit money in, we take money out, and we have money stored or saved in our account. So a hydrologic budget is similar. Instead of the system being our bank account, it's a hydrologic system. All hydrologic systems are comprised of components of the hydrologic cycle. Remember, a hydrologic cycle is composed of precipitation, evaporation, transpiration, infiltration, various types of surface and subsurface runoff, and storage. It accounts for the inputs, outputs, and storage of a hydrologic system, as shown in this example. For example, the following are some types of inputs. Please note that this is just some of the possible inputs and is not an inclusive list. Upstream flow. This is the flow entering the system directly through a river. Groundwater flow, defined as through flow, where groundwater enters the storage due to the subsurface water level being higher than the surface water level. Overland runoff, this is the water that comes into the system through the perimeter of the control volume. And precipitation, which enters directly into the control volume. Some examples of outputs include downstream flow. This is the flow exiting the system directly through a river. Groundwater. This is the water exiting the system through infiltration. Flooding. Water leaving the perimeter of the system. Evaporation. Flows evaporating from the surface of the system. And transpiration. Flows evaporating from vegetation within the system. And finally, the storage is the control volume of the system itself. As mentioned earlier, this could be a lake, a river, a roadway, and so many other things. The governing equation for a hydrologic budget is the input minus the output equaling the storage. Both input and output are rates of water. A rate is something per unit time. In our case, we'll be dealing with depth of water per unit time, like a rainfall intensity, an area of water per unit time, or a volume of water per unit time, like a flow rate. The storage is the change of storage over a time span. Thus, inputs, I, minus outputs, O, are equal to a change in S, or storage, over a change in T, or time. Let's do an example to help explain the hydrologic budget further. You're given a segment of the Los Angeles River. Note, the river is concrete and flows cannot infiltrate. Determine the inputs, outputs, and storage of your control volume. The first step is to draw a schematic of the problem statement. In this example, I have drawn a top view of the LA River. I've identified the control volume. Now, I'm ready to think about the inputs and outputs of our system. Examples of inputs for our system include the upstream flow from the LA River, the overland runoff from the surrounding area, flows from storm drains directly connected to the river, and precipitation. Outputs include downstream flow leaving the system, flooding when the water levels are too high to be contained in the river, evaporation from the surface, and transpiration from the vegetation. And that leaves our control volume, which is the segment of the LA River. So in blue, highlighted, we've got the inputs. Highlighted in red, we have outputs, and highlighted in green is our storage. We can add new numbers to these problems and solve a hydrologic budget. But this gives you a basic understanding of what a hydrologic budget is.